actual study. Loading speed of modern websites and reliability of online speed test services. Okay. Yeah, introduction, state of the art, there are many terms. Yeah, so they just describe what they mean. Cause of slow loading of websites. It is well researched that loading speed of the website has a significant influence on a user. What things can cause it? Sometimes a website loads slowly, uselessly, but simply because it is not optimized. Sometimes lower speed is an intentional payment for better UX. Size of images. We just went over that. Responsive web design. Marcotte wrote that we're designing for more devices, more input types, more resolutions than ever before. He answered this challenge with responsive design. Responsive website can display web content differently according to the particular device, its screen size, and capabilities on which it is being reviewed. Resizing a desktop image to fit a mobile's device screen, however, implies downloading an image that's been suited for a desktop environment, which is an unnecessarily large file. Many web designers tend to use the simplest method available. Common way of dealing with this issue is hiding too large images and other content for smaller displays. It does not solve the problem with downloading too much data when it is not needed. The image will not be displayed, but they will still be downloading, causing delay in page load speed. And if you use CSS media queries to replace the background image with a mobile version, in some cases it would download both images. Another common way of dealing with images is shrinking. As responsive web design uses fluid images to match the different screen sizes, desktop-grade image is downloaded every time, even when loaded on a much smaller screen. Okay, this is actually a pretty good argument, and I would actually go one step further. Not only does a poor, not well thought out responsive design lead to actually just downloading more stuff, but get this. You actually have to generate more code to accommodate more devices and resolutions, which logically entails the necessity of having to download more stuff to accommodate this. So, on the one hand, you can say hardware is getting better. We have phones. You don't need desktops all the time now, et cetera, et cetera. On the other hand, you can say that the schisms caused by the variety of hardware leads to generating more code to accommodate all this new hardware. Does one cancel the other out? I'm not sure. Is one worse than the other? I'm not sure, but it is a factor. Just taking some notes. JavaScript. According to Baker, Barker, JavaScript is potentially the largest area for improvement when trying to address the total performance. Websites relying heavily on JavaScript, especially those with Ajax, can experience performance issues. Soldiers tested the Alexa top 100 URLs with and without JavaScript and demonstrated improvement of an average performance of 31% when removing JavaScript from a website. Holy crap. Of course, the solution to faster loading speeds is not removing JavaScript completely. Web designers should rather learn to use it more efficiently. The entire premise of what I'm trying to get to. Motivation to learn programming properly is, however, a big problem these days. Holy crap, this study was meant for me! Because of the limitless resources available on the internet, one does not have to learn a lot to create a plausibly functional website. This trend can be simply confirmed by looking at a question and answer site for professional enthusiast programmers called Stack Overflow. Often the questions are so basic with respect to the relevant field of knowledge that it is apparent that people who ask them are lacking of fundamental knowledge. Is this just an academic study to take a dump all over programmers? Yet they're trying to create a website. Some of them are even trying to do it for business. Damn, that's good. Another issue of JavaScript, apart from bad programming techniques, is its overuse. Academic paste. Hey, Quad, how are you doing, man? Inexperienced developers often download whole JavaScript libraries in order to add functionality, which could be accomplished in cleaner and more efficient ways. Sometimes they do not need the libraries, they just incorporate them into the website as part of a useful package of functions because it is simple. The same goes for front-end frameworks such as Bootstrap or Foundation, which offer a collection of code, styles, and functions. Damn! Now we're talking. That's what you said yesterday, that's right, Laugh. And this is a legit study. Recommendations. Many of the discussed performance issues can be solved. However, we need to distinguish between an ignorance or inactivity regarding online performance and design intent with calculated balance between website attractiveness and performance. On the other hand, in this section, we summarize and propose some of the general available solutions. size of images, responsive web design, JavaScript, speed tests. So they go into how they did their speed tests, what they used, the settings, locations, caveats in terms of reliability, performed speed tests, and there they do. Yep, there we go. So an actual academic study with speed loading speed. Yeah, this is great. Our results indicate that the choice of browser and location affects significantly testing of website loading speed. This turns out to be a very serious issue in the case of comparing test results, which we however need in most cases. Either we compare between our website and competitive sites, or we compare previous versions of our site with the current one. The lengthy and costly process of redesigning a website is often based on these results, so it's important they're very reliable. Okay. I wonder if there are references here that would be useful, but this is a good one. Car, my diploma course mentioned none of this. Was just get all of Bootstrap. Right, Car, right? Right. And when you enter the business world, businesses also focus on the same thing. They sit you down and they go, hey, we need this thing to work. Performance isn't usually called out as a thing that it needs to work. And even if it is, if you go to like a manager or an executive and say, well, you get one of two choices. You can either have this thing now, but the performance sucks, but it works, it's functional. Or you can have this thing later, but it's not functional, but the performance will be great later. Most executives and managers will go, I want it now. Application and testing of the conceptual spirit on techniques, technique to website design. Yeah, this is good.